Hello my friends. My name is Bot Mathematician, and this is Hollowmancer. Since the release of Hearthstone, players have been arguing about the cost of the game. These debates still occur today.
We don't want to teach developers how to sell their free-to-play game. We decided to recreate the entire financial situation and show you the evolution of the economy of the game.
In this video you will learn how many packs are needed to collect the complete collection of cards, how much gold each player can earn, and most importantly, is the game becomes more expensive or less expensive from year to year?
To answer these questions, we conducted a large-scale study. We tried to determine the most important factors that have an impact on the cost of the game for each player, then we did the calculations. The results surprised us a lot. We worked very hard on this, and think we did a great job, so we would be very grateful if you could click the like button, share this video and subscribe to the channel.
What? Who?
The most important components of the game economy are packs, gold, dust, and of course real money.
One pack contains 5 cards, one card is guaranteed to be rare or better. The cost of one pack in the store is $1.50, if you buy 60 packs for $70, then a pack costs $1.17. You can buy a pack for 100 gold. On average, if you disenchant all cards from a pack, you get 100 units of arcane dust. Yes, I know your packs seem to always contain only 40 dust, but you can't argue with statistics. The main goal of the game is to collect as many cards as possible, and for this you need to buy packs or craft the most necessary cards using dust.
Now let's move on to our research. For this, we must go back to March 11th, 2014, the day of the game's release.
At the time of launch, only the classic set was available for purchase. Let's try to calculate the resources that players could earn in the game.
For visualization on the chart, let's use the icons of two players. This is Squire and Tyrion. They are the same skill level, and play the same amount of time, but one of them is a free-to-play player, and the second invests regularly into the game, because his main goal is to obtain the full collection.
The main game resource for all players is gold. You can get gold by completing daily quests, winning against an opponent in battle mode, and playing arena. Every day, the player received one daily quest. The reward for finishing this quest was from 40 to 100 gold, and very rarely, one classic pack. Quests with a small reward were received more often than quests with a big reward. For convenience, we first converted all the awards into gold. On average, in 2014, each player earned 48 gold coins per day.
Also, for 3 victories in battle mode, a player received 10 gold coins. Let's imagine that each of our players achieved 6 victories every day. This means that they earned 20 gold each.
Players also received one-time rewards for completing the training mode, and rewards for completing hidden quests. Converting it all into gold, we get 1200 gold. And so, 2 months after the release, they earned 2,880 gold for quests, 1,200 gold for victories, plus 1,200 for tasks for beginners. For this amount of resources they could get 53 packs. Is this enough? Let's see.
We do not want to bore you with information about the rarity of cards and the chance of their falling out of the packs. In order to collect a complete classic set, it was necessary to purchase approximately 470 packs. Provided that you disenchanted all the extra copies and gold cards, then craft missing cards from dust. Thus, Tyrion had to pay $470 for 420 packs, in order to have a complete collection.
In the next 4 months, the first adventure, Curse of Naxxramas, was added to the game. It is a 5-wing adventure, and for completing each wing the player received new cards. There are a total of 30 collectible cards. Access to this adventure amounted to 3,500 gold. During this period, Squire bought this adventure for gold and was able to collect resources for 47 additional packs. Tyrion bought himself this adventure for real money, so he got an exclusive card back and saved resources for the future. At the end of 2014, the first expansion, Goblins vs. Gnomes, was released. It brought 123 collectible cards, 20 of which were legendary. To collect the full collection, it was necessary to buy 310 packs. Squire was able to buy 82 packs for gold, and Tyrion bought an additional 117 packs for $190.
In general, in 2014, players earned resources that are equivalent to about 181 packs, and the players' expenses for the full collection amounted to $750. We understand that this framework is very sketchy, and it does not take into account a lot of factors. For example, arena rewards, additional game bonuses and promotions, as well as discounts on packs during events. But in spite of this, we did our best to look at the past as well as we could.
Let's continue, and move on to 2015. Initially, the developers planned to alternate between adventures and expansions. Unlike adventures, expansions cost very little gold, and they give players the opportunity to earn additional resources before an expensive expansion.
We are convinced that according to the financial results of 2015, developers had to revise their approach. In 2015, we got two adventures and one expansion. Not all of them required a large investment of resources from the players.
Additionally, a weekly tavern brawl was presented. The reward was one pack of cards for the first win each week. One card pack per week really has an impact on the economy, and on top of this, we got rewards for ranks. If you had a great collection and experience, then you could reach the fifth rank, even with only 6 victories per day. The reward for this achievement is equivalent to about 5 packs. In addition, new quests for 50 gold were presented, although they did not significantly affect the player's income, since players received them quite rarely. According to statistics from Reddit in 2015, after the release of new quests, quests for 60 gold have become less common for players.
At the end of the year, Squire was able to get resources for 209 packs, and 2 adventures for free. This is an excellent result. Tyrion spent only $200 for the full card collection that year. The problem is, if you were a new player and you started playing in 2015, you needed to pay about $1,138 to collect all cards.
Now for 2016. This year there were 2 expansions and 1 adventure. To collect all the cards, it was necessary to purchase 640 packs, and spend 3,500 gold on an adventure. We also got the division of the game into 2 formats, Wild and Standard. Also this year, players were given the opportunity to invite friends to the game, and new quests were added to Battle with Friend. If you battled a friend while you had this quest, both you and your friend would earn 80 gold, which significantly influenced the game economy. After all, it was possible to get benefits from friends. Without much effort, everyone could receive 3 invitations from friends per month and earn an additional 240 gold.
Let's look at the results of the year. Squire was able to earn resources that are equivalent to 339 packs. Tyrion had to pay $355 for the full collection. If you came into the game from the beginning of 2016, by the end of the year you would need to pay $1,333 to have all of the available cards from Standard Mode. As you can see, the cost of a complete collection for new players continues to grow from year to year, even though the division into Wild and Standard Modes occurred.
Now let's look at the results of 2017. According to the original plans of the developers, we were supposed to get 2 adventures and 1 expansion again, but the sad experiences of the past did not allow it. The developers came up with something better. From this moment onwards, we were told we would receive 3 expansions per year. This means that we need to spend more resources, but there were also many positive things to come about after this decision. Since the year of Mammoth, we no longer receive copies of legendary cards. But on the other hand, now the number of legendary cards has changed in new sets from 20 to 23. In any case, to collect a full set, you need to purchase about 270 packs. We also received a large amount of dust for the cards that were sent to the Hall of Fame.
Thus, players were able to collect the amount of resources equivalent to about 426 packs. However, in order to collect the complete collection, it was necessary to spend an additional $480. A new player who began to play from the beginning of 2017 needed to spend about $1,545.
Well, finally, we will move to 2018. This year, the developers have maintained their economic course. There were changes in the quest system, and we stopped receiving 40 gold quests. The new ranks were finally created for new players, and for successfully passing to rank 25, they now receive 25 packs. But despite these innovations, for a new player, the game has become even more expensive once again. According to the results of the year, the players received a quantity of resources which is equivalent to 418 packs. This figure is slightly lower than in 2017 because we received much less dust for the cards that were sent to the Hall of Fame. A complete collection of cards in 2018 costs $480.
So finally, we can come to several conclusions. The first conclusion: Hearthstone is a very expensive card game.
No!
You can play it absolutely free, but you must be stubborn and use your resources correctly. Without investing real money, you will hardly be able to collect the entire collection of cards, but this is not necessary for a successful duels.
The second conclusion: Hearthstone was the most expensive in 2014.
Conclusion 3: Hearthstone was the cheapest in 2015.
The fourth conclusion: Hearthstone is becoming more loyal to the players who have been playing for a long time. We get more resources, even more than we give in these statistics, as we have large and small events, bonus rewards, promotions, and gifts before the release of new expansions that aren't taken into consideration here.
Conclusion 5: Hearthstone is very unfriendly to new players. Since the launch of the game, for new players the game has only become more expensive. This needs to be changed more radically. New players should receive many more bonuses and many more free packs.
Conclusion 6: Developers have experimented with the economic system of the game, but it seems they have found the perfect solution for themselves. If you play and you want the entire collection of cards of the current year, you have to pay $480.
Conclusion 7: For all this time, in order to have a complete collection of cards, it would be necessary to spend $2,300.
So the main question that does not leave my head: what awaits us in 2019? Will we see changes in the economy of the game? What do you think about this? We created a YouTube poll. Find the button on the screen, please vote and share your opinions in the comments.
In my opinion, this year was not the most financially successful for Hearthstone. In support of this, by the end of the year, some players received a link to a large survey from developers. In this survey, there were many questions concerning the financial aspects of the game. You can still vote in the unofficial version of this poll on Google Forms. Alright, that's all for today. Thank you for being with us.
And special thanks to Chris for text editing.
We will meet in new videos.
Good luck.